Morning, students. As you can see that page 128, History of English Drama, we are going to start that, section 4. Now this will go in detail. Now in this particular part, that is drama section, you have to pay attention to all the periods, all the types of comedy, and as I am reading, as I'm telling you, I'll keep underlining that with the pencil. So come to the introduction part first. How dramatic you are is your response when a friend exaggerates. So, whether in appearance or whether in a conversation, you know, when you see the behavior of a person, you really feel that, you know, they are really enacting, and you say how dramatic you are. Now, what is actually drama in general? Drama means it is speaking with expression, gestures, okay, the behavior on the stage, the scenery behind, then the costumes, the stage, the public, and how your performance is, and you come to know the performance when the people applaud, when they clap, that your performance is really good. How dramatic you are is your response when a friend exaggerates or overreacts. It means that you're correctly using the adjective form of the word drama. Now, underline, drama is a performance which is essential, loud, exaggerated, and larger than life. Underline. Drama is a performance which is essentially loud, exaggerated, and larger than life. It is an audio-visual medium. See, all these parts are important. When the question is given, what is drama, you have to explain that. It is an audio-visual medium. You can see, you can hear. The audience sitting around in front of close to or in the last row of the theater should be able to hear and see the actor on the stage. So that is why the stage is at a height. For example, a stage whisper is far louder than a whisper in real life. This would be an example of willing suspension of disbelief. It can be defined as, now this is defined as willingness to accept the unreal. Willingness to accept the unreal means, sometimes, you know, the dramas are, they're fiction, you know, imaginary. All are not real. So this is the willingness to accept what the performer is enacting. It may also mean sacrifice of realism and logic for the sake of enjoyment. For the sake of enjoyment, people can twist and turn the facts also, make it interesting so that people enjoy it. The term was coined by the poet and aesthetic philosopher Samuel T. Coleridge. The term often applies to fictional works of action, comedy, fantasy, and horror genres. It refers to the willingness of the audience to overlook the limitations of a medium. Now underline this. Drama is a medium of expression whereby performers express themselves artistically. Drama is a medium of expression whereby performers express themselves artistically. The performance is based on a script, which is in the form of dialogues, whereas a story or novel is written in the narrative form. So this, someone else writes the the dialogues, and the performer learns those dialogues, and he or she enacts, speaks loudly. Now underline this also. Poetry is language expressed in rhythm and meter. Poetry is language expressed in rhythm and meter. There is a certain meter. Sonnets are there. Then rhyme scheme is there. Okay, stanzas are there. So a particular pattern is there in poem. That is rhythm and meter. Drama is the specific mode of fiction represented in performance. See, so many examples are there. So now, all the examples or definitions you may not write. Sometimes they may come as fill in the blanks. So you have to learn all this, underline this. Poetry is the language expressed in rhythm and meter. Drama is the specific mode of fiction represented in performance. A play, opera, mime, and ballet are performed in the theater, on radio, or television. Okay, so that was a short introduction to what drama is. Now, we will go to the different aspects of it. What is drama? Now, again, there's another definition. Drama is a composition in verse or prose to be acted on the stage, in which a story is related by means of a dialogue and action and is represented with accompanying gesture, costume, and scenery as in real life. Now, this is the actual definition according to Oxford Dictionary. What is drama? So, a question may come, what according to Oxford Dictionary is drama? So, you have to write this definition. Now, drama is a composition. Now, there are many meanings, many ways of describing. Drama is a composition designed for performance in the theater, in which actors take the roles of characters, perform the indicated action, and utter the written dialogue. Now, this is like, you know, you can explain in your own words. But this will definitely come, what according to Oxford Dictionary, or give the definition of drama according to Oxford Dictionary. Next page, elements of drama. Elements of drama are very, very important. Now, all these parts are very important and you have to learn them. Elements means which are the different parts where the drama can take place. Means what exactly is required. The requirements. The elements of drama are plot. Now, what is plot? Plot is important. Unless you have the plot, written script, that is, the idea and the theme, you cannot have the drama. So that is the first requirement, the plot, the whole, the scene, written down scene or the play, that is plot. Then comes the characterization, now, characters, how many characters will be there in that plot, in that drama. Then dialogue, dialogues have to be written, yes. No. You're mixing up that plot, area of land with this plot. That plot is different. Where a person stays, person has a plot of land is different. But plot here exactly is the whole thing written down. Means what you have in your presence. How the whole thing is going to be. Yeah. The plot, then characterization, the characters. Main characters and then side roles and those sub characters. Then dialogue. Dialogue is important, that has to be written down. Stage directions. Now, stage directions also has to be there. Who will come from which side and what will be behind there to show whether they are the performers are in some hall or whether what kind of scenery it is, that has to be set up. That is on the stage, conflict. Now, they say a drama should have a conflict. Why conflict? Because now see, most of the stories, novels, dramas, even movies, what is there? There is a conflict. Conflict means or some kind of this way, a problem where it has to be solved. So the writer, what he does, he creates the problem, that is the conflict, between the characters, how the characters are going to fight out or sort out that problem. And that is it. He will create the conflict and he will also try to solve it in this. So that is conflict. Conflict is important. Straight away, you know, a person is going somewhere and something has to happen. So that is conflict. And how he's going to solve it. So conflict has to be there. Then theme. Theme, of course, the central idea of the play. What it's about the king's rule, it's about the queen's this, you know, behavior towards the public or what the queen did. So that theme is important. What the play is about. It is about social life, it is about the rulers, it is about the politics of the country, or it is about just giving some message, you know, teaching some mannerisms and all that, you know, for social, teaching some social behavior, some kind of criticism. So that is the thing. Then, so these are important, the elements of the drama, the plot, characterization, dialogue, setting. Yes? Still, now still, when you see a play, I don't know, you sometimes on TV, I don't know, many have not seen a play. In school, you must have seen. See, you have a stage on the school. You have a stage in the school and some performance is going on. Now, which character will come from which side? Now, that is all arranged. All cannot just come, you know, at the same time. First, the hero will come, the king will come, and then the assistant or some minister will come, and how they will sit, how they will face, because they cannot back the audience. Okay, they have to face the audience. So, and the audience should know that they are in some central hall discussing some issue. So that is the stage direction. And if it is a dance performance, half the characters will come from the left, the other half will come from the right. So all that stage directions and all that is important. That is stage direction. Then the four closely related areas of focus. Now, focus. What is to be given more importance? The focus of the scene. Focus of the scene. The scene. The scenes are very important. What is there? How the characters are going to stand, and how they are going to this thing face the audience, and what is behind? That is important. How they will view that scene. The focus of the audience. The audience has to be, the audience also has to be, the arrangement has to be, sitting arrangement has to be such that the audience can see and hear all the characters, and the characters are facing them. So this is the focus, that the characters should face the audience and they should understand what they are enacting. Focus of the character, again, character, main character, or, you know, the other characters, small characters, which have no little this, you know, appearance on the stage. So the character has to be focused, has to be seen, viewed properly by the audience. The focus and focus of the character also means that, you know, all the more of more importance is given to that particular character according to lights and directions, according to his gestures, according to his, so that focus of the character. Focus of the actor. Actor, of course, they have to, you know, be clearly visible by the audience, and they have to perform in such a way that they are understood by the audience. So this is the focus, four areas. Then means the camera should be nicely the same on them. The light should be thrown properly and they on these characters, on the scenes, on the actors, even on the audience. After then the objectives. Now what is the objective of the drama? Why this drama is important? After studying this unit, you will be able to understand and identify drama as a genre of literature. Genre of literature, it's a part of literature. See, literature is poetry, fiction, okay, and drama. Learn the definition of drama that is there. Yeah, you will learn it on, yes, given there earlier. Learn the definition of drama. Explain the difference between drama and other forms of literature. Means, what is fiction, what is prose, what is poetry, and what is drama? So you should know the definition. Definition, poetry and drama is already given the definition. What is prose? Prose is a written thing, it may be fact or fiction, written in the order to explain so that the reader can understand. And it is in paragraphs and it goes to lengths. Sometimes it goes to pages like a novel. Or even a short story. So that you have to see. Now we will do that. Explain the basic elements of drama. Now, basic elements of drama we did above, what is that? Plot, characterization, dialogue, setting, stage directions, and conflict. Now, this particular thing is given very nicely on page 130. Okay, that we'll see that column is given there, and you can understand that nicely. Understand the types of drama. Now, this is important. What types of drama are there? Because we have three dramas here in the text. It can be tragedy. Some about, those Shakespeare's dramas are there about tragedy, Hamlet and all. Comedy. Okay. And tragic comedy. Tragic plus comedy. So Shakespeare's dramas fit in all these types of drama. That is tragedy, comedy, and tragic comedy. Now, comedy, again, now these have different parts. Romantic comedy, it can be about romance. Sentimental comedy, yes. Sentimental also. Classical, it is there, connected to something. Classical music, or it can be that. Comedy of humor. Humor, making fun of others, and that comedy also. Comedy of manners. Manners also fits in there. So these are different types of drama. Now, when you come to the next page, yes. Where there is a mixture of both tragedy and comedy. That is tragic comedy. Now, which particular this of Shakespeare, we'll have to take the list. That is tragic comedy. Where there is tragedy plus comedy, and where the comedy is based on, there's fun made on that kind of tragedy. That is tragic comedy. Means in between tragedy, there is some humor also. So that is tragic comedy. Now that examples I'll give next time, because we have to take down the list of Shakespeare's plays, and we'll know which is tragic comedy and which is comedy of humor. Because he has written all the types of drama and those plays, historical as well. Come to the next page, we'll have more of it. That is on page 130. Elements of drama. It is given very nicely here. Plot. Now, what is in the plot? Series of events occurring in the play. As I said, it is a play, and it has to, follow one particular sequence from the beginning to a story. Entire play written down is the plot. It means plan, scheme, or pattern. A pattern in which the writer writes from the beginning till the end, the play. It has beginning, middle, and the end. So this is clearly given what exactly is the plot. The next you have the characters. The most important element of drama is, of course, the characters, the main character especially. The protagonist. Now, who is the protagonist? Is the leading character. Leading character can be male, female. So that is protagonist, is the main character in the play. The other characters are major, minor, static, and dynamic, flat, and wrong. This means, the different roles that they play. Some just come for humor, to make people laugh. So some just have a minor role, like a servant or something. Some are really, they're dynamic in the sense, they come and they create some horror, some kind of this in the play. And flat and round, which have appearance is very minor. Then you have characterization. It means to reveal peculiarities of the characters. Now, characterization. Are the characters, and characterization is what they are going to enact, what they want to tell the public, what they want to show the public. So that is characterization. And then comes to gain insight into their personalities, establish connections with them. Gain insight into the personalities means what? Their characterization should be such that the audience can actually, you know, feel through them. That feeling should be there. Yes, this is the ruler and this is what he's doing, and he's bad or good or whatever it is. And the character has to be praised, liked by the audience. So, you know, why do people like some of the plays and some of the characters, if you have heard of some, see, there are some this hall, Borivali, we have that hall, they have those Marathi and Gujarati plays, and all the shows go full. Now, why they go full? That is the Thackeray Hall near college. All the shows go full because there are many people who don't like movies, you know. Why they don't like movies? That is all artificial and fake and just music and that. But in play, why do many like the play? They are face to face with the characters and they can make out every gesture and the way they act and all. So they like it. They like the plays. So, and the theater actors are appreciated by the audience, more of them. Then come to dialogue. Dialogue, it involves two speakers. Now, dialogue, you know, hearing and listening. So audience has to be there. And now, monologue. Now, if you have read Shakespeare's Hamlet, it's more of a monologue. Of course, it's a tragedy and play. But all the time, Hamlet tries to speak to himself, to be or not to be. He cannot decide what he should do. So he's speaking to himself. That is monologue. And soliloquy, character's thought process expressed along, means what is inside his mind and heart. He's expressing that loudly. Then it reveals the nature of the character and gives us information about his relations. So naturally, when Hamlet is speaking, we come to know like what is in his mind. He's so confused whether he should murder or not, murder his uncle or not. So he's so confused because he is very young. And what I think I must be knowing the story. Story is that, you know, Hamlet's father was poisoned, who was the ruler, was poisoned by his own elder brother. Snake poison in his ear, and he died. And nobody knew about it. And he was like, you know, after that, he gets dreams. Hamlet gets the dream that his father is coming to him and telling him that, see, I did not die a natural death. I was poisoned. And you take revenge, his father tells him. I'm going off the track. Okay, his father tells him to take revenge. And he doesn't know what to do because his uncle has married his mother. Means, now father is dead, his own mother has married this uncle. Uncle wants to be the ruler. So that is why he murdered his brother. Now, his father appears to him and tells him to take revenge. And the mother doesn't know that he has murdered, that this the brother-in-law has murdered. Go to see, poisoned him. So now, Hamlet being very young, now see, we are coming to this. He doesn't know what to do. He's so confused. He's hardly 17 or 18. And he doesn't know how to take revenge and all that. So that is the soliloquy and monologue. And when he's acting, this performance is there on the stage, people come to know that, yes, this is in his mind and this is what he's confused of. Okay, next one, stage directions. Now in stage directions, you have performance of the actors during the course of the development of the story along with the use of set. Yeah. Now, stage means not just scenes behind. It is also music, light, and costumes. Then, stage directions are the guidelines, suggestions given by the dramatist. Okay. It is the essence of then conflict. Conflict is very important. Now see, what Hamlet is facing is the conflict. So that has to be shown to the audience. It is the essence, very important part of the drama. Conflict has to be there. It enlightens life, grants dignity and worth to human life. Now what happens? Many conflicts that are there in the drama, what they do is, see, conflict is there and they are solving that, the characters are solving that issue, whatever is there. And the public learns, seeing that, yes, if such a thing happens, this can be done. Or this should be done. They can even give suggestions later on. It would have been better if the character had done this and all. So it is like, you know, giving some kind of guidelines to the audience. In such situation, what the characters did and what the characters should do and what the public audience should do if such a thing happens. Theme. The main idea, the point of a play stated as generalization. Now, theme is the, of course, most important part where they have the central idea, as you have in the poem and other. Central idea which the audience should understand, on which the whole play is depending. That is the theme. So that is, now this you have two students. Now I'm not going further because there is a lot further in this particular chapter because you have to learn a lot. So now what you have to do is you have to learn the definition of drama. Definition of poem, I tell you all, that is very important. Definition of drama according to Oxford Dictionary, according to simple words, two ways you learn. Then definition of poetry, which is there on page 128. Poetry is a language expressed in rhythm and meter. Then the elements of drama. Now these are all important questions which will come in the form of where, fill in the blanks, complete the following. Now, what are the elements of drama? At least 4 to 5 we should know because 2 marks questions. Then related areas of focus, that also you have to do. Then you have to come to types of drama. Types, how many types of drama are there? Learn that by heart. And then you have to come to this page 130, you have to learn this. So plot, what is plot? It's given. Characters. Character, all that is given in detail there on that. Yes. So this you'll have to learn. And this is the homework you have to learn. So far, because then the next one also is also all learning the different periods that are there. So that I will do next time. It will become too much. So learn this first, learn this much. And of course, those 3 plays which are there afterwards, the drama, they are very interesting. But before that, you have to know all these, all this about modern, the remaining, that short history of drama also we have to learn. And so learn this much first, the introduction and the elements of drama. That is important, very important. Any doubts you'll have? Now, there is still time. There's a lot of time. Can you this the in the past, this thing, what was that chapter? See, we have the test, I think, next week or the date is not decided. We will be having the unit test of 25 marks. Now, 25 marks, the portion syllabus is already given there. And so, if you all have any doubts regarding the prose and the poetry part or the writing skills, if you all have missed, so please ask. And this you have to learn. That history of English drama. This will be in the next terminal exam. Of course, not for this unit test. Now, regarding this unit test, if there is anything, grammar, if you all want, I'll do more grammar. And follow that portion, which is given for the unit test. From there, do you have any doubt? Any doubt regarding that, those writing skills, poetry, prose? If you all have, now what you all should do is, listen, students, you all, nobody is asking any doubts. Whatever is done, I did this today. Now you all must, evening or some time when you get the time, once you should at least go through it and then ask what it is. Otherwise, what happens? At the end, you will not be able to understand the whole thing. So, and it becomes clear once and for all. So, any doubts you'll have? I'm not going further. Hello. Students, any doubts? We will stop here. Okay, thank you, students.
Bye.
Happy New Year, students. I forgot to wish you. Wish you all a very happy New Year.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye.